welcome back, familia, to our El Peso Hero audio comic book series. I hope you enjoyed El Peso Hero, La Cuerda de las Espadas, the origin story of Ignacio Rivera. For our second episode, we are going to jump into the Amazing Border Stories anthologies. Basically, it's a three-set comic book series where it's El Peso Hero in the border, overcoming obstacles, being that super humanitarian, right? So one thing to note that within that world, which I started writing, I started writing 2014. So just to go through and go through the video, the episode through that lens of that world in 2014. But you know what? A lot of things haven't changed. There's a lot of work to be done in that area of that humanitarian crisis. But it's something that has captivated many with El Peso Hero, and it's something that still holds true until today. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Let us know what you think down in the comments below, and I'll see you next week. Adios.
Released in 2015, El Peso Hero Border Stories chronicles Ignacio's super humanitarian adventures across the border. This book in particular has garnered high praise and has received a lot of media attention. Protecting and fighting for immigrants, El Peso Hero is a superhero like no other. The amazing art you'll see was created by one of our ongoing artists, our friend Chema. Hope you enjoy. La Bestia, the Beast. 20 miles south of Nuevo Laredo, as many as 500,000 Central American refugees hop on board freight trains collectively known as La Bestia, cargo trains that run multiple lines carrying products north for export. As there are no passenger rail cars, migrants must ride atop the moving trains, facing physical dangers that range from amputation to death. We are introduced to brothers Gonzalo and Astro. They're both minors traveling without a guardian. Central American migrants are subject to extortion and violence at the hands of the gangs and organized crime groups that control the routes north. La Bestia is forced to stop by a fleet of trucks. Nestor and Gonzalo try to make a dash to safety. Some were not so lucky. Don't move. Their escape is stopped by a cartel sniper. He orders them to follow him. While not noticing, you two come with me. El Peso Hero greets the sniper with an uppercut as El Peso Hero readies another volley. A narco tank crashes into him. For those of you who do not know what a narco tank is, it's basically a reinforced armored plated homemade vehicle. El Peso Hero gets up. Malditos tienen un narco tanque. He lifts the tank and trashes it. The disoriented criminals retreat. Lárganse de aquí. Once everybody is safe, El Peso Hero greets the children. ¿Están bien, niños? El Peso Hero then escorts the rest of the refugees to safety. Síganme los buenos. Gonzalo shares with El Peso Hero that they are trying to reach their father in Houston, Texas. Two nice ladies overhear their conversation and extend their help in looking after them for the rest of the journey. El Peso Hero departs, and Gonzalo thanks El Peso Hero. El fin. The end. Children. 3 miles south of Ciudad Acuña and Del Rio. A hot summer afternoon. Unaccompanied children crossing the southern border into the United States. They face many dangers. Two sisters try to make the perilous, hazardous journey on their own, escaping poverty and violence. A large truck abruptly arrives. A group of men belonging to La Patrona carry hostages to their final destination. The sisters try their best to hide, but are shaken by the sound of gunfire. Hearing a noise, a cartel member sees them. He is then lifted up by the neck by El Peso Hero. Angry, El Peso Hero tells him, ¿Acaso te atreves a disparar a niñas inocentes? You dare to shoot at innocent little girls? Then the cartel member is tossed across into the truck's windshield. El Peso Hero is confronted by a hail of bullets. He picks up the truck and throws it into the direction of the street. Ya están a salvo. You're safe. El Peso Hero extends a hand to the sisters. Están a menos de 5 kilómetros de la frontera. Yo los llevo. El Peso Hero tells them they are 5 kilometers from the border. El Peso Hero escorts them across. He braces them as they cut through El Rio Grande. Once on the other side, they're spotted by the border patrol, and they say their farewells. Estoy a tu servicio. I'm at your service. El Peso Hero says. El Peso Hero goes back across and into the setting sun. And as for the sisters, their journey has just begun. El fin. The end. Sanctuary City, Houston, Texas. A group of upper elementary students walk along together after school. They are playing, singing and dancing, just being kids. Their joy and fun are cut off by a bunch of black Suburbans racing through their neighborhood. One of the students fears the worst. Rosa Maria runs home. Homeland Security, in this case, the deportation force, begin their operation.
Freeze.
As they conduct their immigration sweep, arrests are made. Rosa Maria's father is apprehended. Rosa Maria calls for her father. He tells her to run. Corre, mija, run. In desperation, Rosa Maria bolts out. Officers scramble to catch her until one of them blocks her path. She crashes into one of them and looks up as tears run down her face. Camp Border Freedom, Uvalde, Texas. We cut to a detention camp on the outskirts of Uvalde. It is a small tent city with a large processing center. Buses constantly dropping off people. Rosemaria is now reunited with her father. They are escorted through the tents, going through the process. They are given numbered electronic bracelets with their country of origin. Rosemaria and her father are registered to begin the deportation process. Outside the tent, they hear a commotion as an American veteran has been detained for deportation by mistake. I'm an American citizen. I fought for my country. Rosemaria asks her father, why are they doing this? He replies, they think they're sending us home. Outside the camp, El Peso Hero stands on a hill surveying. Este campo es una injusticia. Los voy a liberar. This camp is an injustice. I will liberate them. To be continued.